First, which criteria should be used to define the ability of a particular country to legislate over and sanction conduct committed on the internet? That's the first question we had to deal with in the lawsuit against Google's local branch. Second, is it legitimate to enforce the company's local office regarding a service that has been operated from the United States? The problem for us is that it's very, very hard to the international cooperation instruments are very weak in order to cope with thousands of reports made by users. So we cannot rely on international cooperation instruments to cope with all these reports that we have been receiving. Third, what are the basic standards that should be adopted by internet service providers in order to cope with human rights violations on the internet? What are the minimum obligations that one can expect from these internet service providers? Fourth, are national law enforcement prepared to deal with a massive number of crimes committed on social network sites? And what if we cannot handle, because I'm talking about 2,000 new cases, confirmed cases of child pornography, child abuse, images distribution on the internet, on social network services. Is there any law enforcement is prepared to cope with this massive number of cases? And lastly, wouldn't it be necessary to ensure minimum levels of transparency and social accountability of social network services? We have the data of Google as Oracle because we're receiving these reports from Google. But what about Facebook, MySpace, Bebo, and other social networking sites? How many cases of child abuse images and other human rights violations do they have? And how many reports did they send to the National Center of Mission Exploiting Child Children in the United States?